Hey, good morning everyone. My name is Vipin Kumar and in this video we are going to learn how to manage virtual machine in Azure with Vagrant. We are covering creating VMs, stopping VMs and terminating VMs. This video is especially for Vagrant lovers. Vagrant is one of the powerful server provisioning tools, and I'm using the Vagrant in my day-to-day operation, not only on my local data center. I'm using the Vagrant on cloud platform, especially on Azure and AWS. So let's look at how you can use Vagrant to manage VMs in Azure. Microsoft released Vagrant Azure provider. The source code and complete steps available on GitHub. I fork the particular repository on my GitHub account. Particular repository name is vagrant-azure. To complete this demonstration, you required couple of the information. For example, you required a application ID and service principal that have the access on Azure resources. If you are very new on the concept service principal in Azure, you can watch my previous video. I created a detailed informative video on this topic. So let's create a application ID or service principal via command line. Connect your Azure subscription via Azure command line and execute this command. Copy the output. We are going to use these information in our Vagrant file. You also required your Azure subscription ID. You can get your subscription ID by using this command. Copy the output in a text file. We are going to use the subscription ID in our Vagrant file. Now we required a Vagrant file. Let's create a Vagrant file. Use the Vagrant init command, and it created a Vagrant file for you. Open the Vagrant file in your favorite text editor. I'm using the Notepad++. This is the default file. Just go ahead and delete all the content and use this specific Vagrant file content. I assume that you have basic knowledge on Vagrant. If you required any assistant on the Vagrant, you can watch a video on my YouTube channel, how to create your lab with the Vagrant. So I'm using the provider Azure, and these lines of the code required to authenticate and authorize on Azure resources. And these are same information we collected from previous command. Azure tenant ID is tenant value. Azure client ID is app ID. Azure client secret is password. Azure subscription ID is Azure subscriptions. You can get your Azure subscription from this command. These line of the code is specific for the VM. Give the group name under which you want to create this particular VM. The location of the resource. So I am using East US Azure VM name. Give the name of your VM. Azure VM URN. Give the image name which you want to deploy on Azure. By default it deploy Ubuntu 16, but for this demonstration I am using the latest Ubuntu 18 image. You can get a complete image list, what other images are available on the Azure, from the Azure CLI. Once you connected your Azure subscription, run this command to get a list of images. So these images are available. So I'm using this URL for Ubuntu 18. Once you decided the URL for your VM, you can provide the virtual network name. These information are optional. If you realize that we haven't discussed about this particular line, this is very important line. Basically, you can use your local SSH key to login on Azure VM from Vagrant console, like Vagrant SSH. So you can create a SSH key any location and upload the private key on the Azure VM by using this Vagrant file. So let's create a SSH key. I'm using the Vagrant on my Windows machine along with Sigwin to get more fields and like Linux. I'm creating the SSH key on this location by using the SSH key gen. I'm okay with this location. No phrases. Local SSH key has been generated, and this particular public key is going to deploy on Azure VM. So this is the complete Vagrant file. You can add more options in the Vagrant file according your requirement. Once you are ready with the Vagrant file, you require to add a Azure dummy box in local Vagrant repository. It is available on this location. I have already added, but let it try. Yes, it is already there. Next one is, you require to install a Azure plugins, and you can install the Azure plugins in the Vagrant by using this command. I have already added this plugin in my Vagrant. Once you complete all the required steps, you are ready to spin up the Azure VM from the Vagrant console. The Vagrant status command is showing that the machine is not created yet. I am using simple Vagrant up command to fire up the VM. It is starting deployment. It is waiting for SSH to become available. It looks like that it is hanging on this process. It is not getting completed. Let's terminate the process. Press Ctrl C. Go to Task Manager. Find a process called Ruby and terminate it. You know what? I am helping you how to troubleshoot the issue with the Vagrant. Let's start Vagrant in debugging mode. This is the command to capture more logs for the Vagrant. Let's fire up. Yes. It is starting the deployment again, but this time in debugging mode. Okay. Let's terminate the process. We encounter the error message. The process was stucking on the SSH, and this is the complete information why it was getting stuck on this step. The error message is SSH key type not supported. It means that the SSH key which we generated not supported by the Vagrant. Let's go ahead, delete and recreate the SSH key with RSA. Let's delete the private and public key. It is done. Now let's create the SSH key with RSA format. This is the command to create the key with RSA format. Okay, the private and public key has been created. Let's fire up the Vagrant up command once again. It is started deployment again. After creating the SSH key with RSA format, so this time you can see here it is completed without any error. We had issue on SSH process, but this time it successfully connected. Let's verify our resource in Azure portal. This is my Azure portal. If I go to virtual machine, our machine is created and running. It got a public IP address and it assigned the required virtual network. By default, port 22 is open. Let's try to connect this machine from Vagrant console. And this is the beauty of the Vagrant. We don't require any other console to manage Azure resource. So command is Vagrant SSH. Great, we successfully connected the Azure Linux machine. Let's verify the hostname. Yes, it is matching the hostname. We can bring down all the process on this machine. So at this moment you are connected the Linux Azure machine and you can perform all your operational work on this machine. Let's log out from this machine. You can also stop the Vagrant machine from the Vagrant console, and the command is Vagrant halt. This command is going to stop the Linux machine. Let's verify in Azure console. So you can see here our machine has been stopped. We can start it again from the Vagrant console, and command is Vagrant up. This command will work to create new image and bring up the machine. Your machine is getting started. We can check the status. It is running. We can verify in the Azure console. It is running now. Now let's come up a scenario where all the deployment work has been done and now you require to delete or terminate all the instance along with the resource group in the Azure cloud. It is very easy to delete all the resources in the Azure cloud with Vagrant. Let's see how. Vagrant destroy is a command. It is prompting a confirmation. Say yes. It is deleting your resource group along with all the services. It has been terminated. We can verify in our Azure portal. My particular resource group is getting deleted along with all the services which we created with the Vagrant file. It is going to take some time. We need to wait it to complete the deletion process. Okay, the resource group has been deleted along with all these services. No more the VMs available on my Azure cloud. So this is the complete demonstration how to manage your Linux VM on the Azure with the Vagrant. Guys, if you haven't started the Vagrant in your development environment, then start it as soon as possible. It is guaranteed you are saving 20 or 25% of your time to managing your development environment. I hope you found this video useful and informative. In this video, that's all. Please join me in next video where we are going to manage our Windows machine with the Vagrant. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day. Bye.